Hello there, my fellow Minecraftians, and you're back with IDED of IDEDOnline, and today we're going to take a look at Better Storage. Here it is. Now, Better Storage has loads of different options of portable ways to move your inventory around with you, and loads of other options available in it. It's a good one, and I'm going to show you how to basically go all of the bits in it today. So, let's have a look at the first part, which is the backpack itself. Now, as you can see there, this is a portable storage pack that you can wear on you. Basically, you put your items in it, as you would normally with any kind of chest, and then once you've done that, you just hold down the crouch button or the sneak button, and then you can click on it and pop. You'll see there it says I've got a piece of armor, and if I open my inventory, you can see it's on the central piece of armor there. And then all you have to do is hold down crouch again, right click, and it puts it back down the floor. So it's a great way to storage a load of different bits and carry them around with you. So to make one of these, you're going to need a U-shape there, an upside down set of trousers basically, of leather, and that will make you the basic outline of it there. You need one piece of wool right in the center and a gold ingot on the top there, and that'll make you this backpack. Now, there's actually another backpack available, which is the Ender backpack. Now, this one's a little bit different because there's only one way to really get this, and the mod developer doesn't tell you, but I'm going to let you in on how you can actually acquire one of these. So what you need to do is keep your eye out for an Enderman actually wearing this, because you're going to see one around. Now, what you need to do is put down like an Ender chest on the floor, and then when he picks it up, he'll drop this backpack. Now, obviously, you can't destroy it normally, because if you do, it'll just teleport away from you. So what you need to do is hold down the sneak button and then destroy it that way, and it will allow you to pick it up, and then that way you have access to all your ender chests via this ender pack. So it's a really good one to have, and I definitely recommend trying to find these ones if you can, but the spawn rate is awfully low. So next up is cardboard. Now, cardboard is a different thing, but completely. Now, to make cardboard, what you're going to need is paper like this. You need 8 sheets of it all together, 6 at the top there, 2 next to it, and 1 slime ball in the corner here. And that'll generate you actually 4 of these cardboard sheets. What will you need cardboard for? Well, there's plenty of items, but the first one is this portable storage container, the cardboard box. It's a one-off use, and once you've filled it up the first time and put it down again, it actually is destroyed. It will not drop another cardboard box. So be aware of that, and this is a little 9-slot extra portable inventory, so it's a good one to have. But still, you make this by putting basically like you would with a actual chest. You put all the cardboard around the outside like that instead of wood planks, and that generates you this cardboard box. Now, next up is the reinforced chest. Now, there's a lot of different variations of these, but unknown to most people and against popular belief, they don't have different stats. It is literally just an aesthetic thing. So they actually are a little bit more robust than a normal chest, but they do not provide different qualities depending on what material you use. It literally is just how they look. So you might want to take that into consideration when you make these. Now, it's a little bit of a bigger chest than a normal one, so it's a little bit better than having a standard chest. And to make these, what you need is you need, now we can replace obviously these bits in the corners here with any of these other materials I've listed, but let's go through. So an iron ingot in each corner like that. You have an upside down bowl shape there of wood, basically, not planks, but actual wood, a chest in the center, and a block of the material at the bottom in the middle here, and that will generate you this reinforced iron chest. Now, you can make it with gold, you can make it with copper, you can make it with steel, diamonds, emeralds, and tin ingots and silver ingots, depending on what mods are available to you, but the basic ones are literally the standard iron version, gold, diamond, and emerald. So those are the versions you can get by standard, and with mods you can get access to these other ones, but they all have the same resistance. Next up is the storage crate. Now, the storage crate, I will just quickly show you the interface here, is a little bit different because the storage crate doesn't give you the same view of the inventory every time, and you can only tell how full it is by this bar up here. As it fills up, it will slowly fill up this bar, and then each time you access it, you'll just see a random selection of items. You can't organize them, but it is a bigger storage capacity than you've normally get. Now, if you can put these together with other storage crates, and you actually give you a larger bar here basically, so you can fill up even more items, but once again it is random the items it shows you, so you might have to keep on accessing it like that to actually get to the items you want to actually take out of it. So a little bit different, but still, to make one of these, what you're going to need is an oak, well, not just oak, but any kind of planks in all of the four corners, sticks in between all of that, and then you will get this, the storage crate. So next up, we're going to look at lockers. Now, lockers are a little bit different. They're basically like a chest, but they open forwards like that. So lockers are a really good one, really alternative use of a chest, and this is how you make them. You're going to need planks like this in a C shape, or you can do it in the reverse C shape, and then you'll need one of these, a trap door, and that can be placed here or there, and that will make you one of these, the locker itself. So it's an alternative use for your trap doors. And now you can make a reinforced version of this, so the reinforced locker. and like the reinforced chests, these ones are literally aesthetic in their looks. They all are slightly more resistant than the standard version, but they do not get better stats based on the material used. It's just how they look. So to make these, what you're going to need is your ingot, your chosen material type in all corners, a block of it in the middle and the bottom. You're going to need your standard locker in the center there, and then the upside down bowl shape of wood there, like that, and that will produce you this reinforced iron locker, or obviously a reinforced gold, diamond or emerald if you're using standard Minecraft, or with mods you can get the copper, tin, silver and steel versions of those. So next up is the keys. Now keys are allowed you to basically lock these, but we'll go through that in a second. So first up, how do you make a key? Well, you need gold and gold nuggets, two of them like that, and then three gold ingots down center like that, and that'll produce you one of these keys. Now what do you want to use the key with? Well, you're going to want to make yourself a lock. Now the keys are individual each time they're created, so when you create a lock you use the key in the center of it. It doesn't use up the key, it will be returned to you, and you'll also get this lock. Now what you need to do is two gold ingots either side at the bottom there like that, in the middle, and obviously a iron ingot in the bottom middle there, and at the very top middle you're going to need another gold ingot, and that will generate you a lock which can only be opened by this key or by other keys with lock picking and etc. like that, but I will explain that shortly. So how about if you want to make a duplicate of the key so you can have your friends unlock that chest? Well, that's possible too with copying keys. So to copy a key, all you need to do is have the original key in that bottom space there, the two gold nuggets right above it, and then the three gold ingots down there in the middle, and that will generate two keys, which obviously is your original key back and then the extra copy. Now what else can you get? Well, you can get a key ring. Now this allows you to store multiple keys on one basically key ring. So what you need is gold nuggets all the way around the outside like that, and that generates you this key ring. Now I'm going to quickly demonstrate it for you here. Here's a key ring I made earlier and I've put some keys onto it. Now how do you do that? Well, you hold the sneak button, you right click, and there you go, you get the key ring interface where you can place these items in there. Now this is a bit confusing, I admit, because you wouldn't be able to tell these two keys apart. It could be either key to actually unlock the chest. Alright, and so next up I'm going to show you the enchantments. Now these are the different enchantments available for locks and keys, so let's have a look at these. First up, I'm going to do the keys. Now the first one is unlocking, which allows it to unlock more than the lock that was actually created from it, so you can unlock more different locks. Now lock picking, invariably similar, allows you to actually unlock chests that maybe weren't made for that key, but then does reduce the enchantment level as you do it. Next up is the morphing, which actually morphs the key into a different key for a different lock, so you could use that several times to get the right key for the unlocking of that specific lock. But next up are the lock enchants. Now the lock enchants, you've got security, which actually basically protects the lock versus enchants like these ones here, so it makes it harder for those to work on that lock. Next up is the enchanted book of persistence. Now persistence, what it does, actually stops people from breaking these locks, which you can do by bashing them with swords or picks, etc., so it makes it harder and harder for people to break it off. Next up is the shock one. Now shock actually does damage to the player trying to basically unlock it, but that's only if they fail. Okay, and the next one is trigger. Now this one's a little bit more unusual, because this actually gives out a redstone signal if they fail to unlock the chest, so it's a good one to use if you're going to set up a redstone, let's say arrow launcher or explosive TNT or something like that, because the reinforced chests are obviously resistant to explosions. It will allow you to then trigger off an explosion, killing the person trying to unlock it if you really want to protect that chest. So let's talk about how you actually color the keys and the locks next, so you can tell the keys apart and the locks, so you could basically color code them to work together. Now first of all, if you wanted to make a completely one color key, all you need to do is surround it completely with the dye of your choice. Here I've done it with bone meal, and you can see it produce a white key. Now if you put just one of the next to it, then you'll see here it will just produce this red band around the center there, and if I just go out of here you can see, look, there you go, I've colored that key completely red and then put one bone meal next to it, and it gave me this one little white stripe here of that color. Next up is though is coloring locks. Now coloring locks is slightly different, but it's still just two colors you can do, and this is how it's done. The same method as before, you literally just surround it with the color that you wish to dye the lock, and you'll see here, look, it comes out of a red lock if you do it all with rose red, and then if you put just one next to it you get the two little bits either side come out with that color. As you can see here, it's a completely white lock and just red bits either side, and that's how you color your locks and your keys, so you can color coordinate them so you know which key goes to which lock. So it's a very useful function to have. Next up is the armor stand. Now the armor stand allows you to store your armor on it. As you can see here, look, here we go, we've got a head, the chest, the legs and the boots all on this armor stand. And how do you make this? Well, you're going to need yourself a stone slab at the bottom, two iron ingots above it in the middle, and then you're going to need a stick either side, and that produces you one of these armor stands. Now, the beneficial factor of this is when you swap your armor onto it, it actually swaps which armor you're wearing, and if you sneak and right click it, it allows you to quickly equip or unequip the item, so you don't even need to have armor on to swap it. Really useful thing to have. But as you can see there, that was the cardboard armor set, and I'm going to show you how to make these. Now, these are actually like a low quality version of the normal armors. They're basically a substitute for like leather armor, because you can actually dye all of these leather with these cardboard bits really easy. So it's a really good setup for like team-based games, and also can be enchanted really easy, because you can enchant all of them in one go, and only using, well, not even using up one book, but actually uses less experience each time you enchant them. So let's cover off the helmet first. It's your standard pattern with cardboard like that, and that'll generate the cardboard helmet. Now the chest, the cardboard chest plate, is done in the same way as a normal chest plate. It's just cardboard pieces like that, and that generates you your cardboard chest plate. Next, the cardboard leggings, and you've guessed it, yep, it's the standard pattern, but just with cardboard for the leggings. And then, of course, last but not least, the cardboard boots. And there we go, it's just two either side, like the standard recipe, pops out that. But you can also get cardboard tools, like a cardboard pickaxe. Now, these, as you can see here, is just cardboard along the top, and then you use sticks, as you do with a standard pattern. And there is also the cardboard axe, same pattern as normal, just with the sticks and the cardboard around the outside there. Same thing for a cardboard shovel, you've just got the one at the top, the two sticks below, and that pops that out. And then the cardboard sword has got those two like that, and stick below it there. And last but not least, the cardboard hoe, which has got the two there and the sticks below it. And all of these can actually be coloured and enchanted. Now, the more enchants that are put on them, the actual higher level of durability they gain. So they actually become more resistant as they go up in enchants. So that's something worth noting, because they do start off weaker than standard tools, but can actually be made to have a higher resistance. Now, next up is the crafting station. Now, this is the last item I'm going to show you from this mod today. And the crafting station is kind of like a standard crafting table, except here you go, look, you've got this awesome little inventory beneath it. So if you put the items in there, you can pretty much auto craft by clicking on here, and it will just keep pulling out the items and pulling the items into craft, which is a really useful function for it. Now, to make this though, it's a little bit overly expensive, because you're going to need your standard crafting table in the center there. You're going to need pistons either side of it. You're going to need stone bricks either side at the top there, and oak planks or any other type of planks at the bottom. And then you're going to need a storage crate in the bottom middle, and then a weighted pressure plate in the top middle, and that'll generate you this crafting station. So that's pretty much everything from the Better Storage mod. There's loads of storage options for you there, some really cool items, and loads of cool like dyeable armors and tools there for you. So remember, if you enjoyed this and you found it informative and helpful, chuck us a like, chuck us a subscribe, and it'll be great to hear any comments or any questions you have. So just let me know, and don't forget at the moment to enter our subscriber giveaway that we're doing. We're giving away 30 games, over £100 worth of games, or over $200 worth of games to our subscribers. So thank you for watching, remember to enter, and I look forward to seeing you soon.